Why is it important that we understand examples and non-examples?
When you want students to understand what makes a certain thing what it is, you can't allow for any sort of misunderstanding to creep in, particularly if they're going to rely on that further on in the arc of learning.
Now, we're going to do examples and non-examples of some body systems.
If you have faulty understanding at the outset, it's just going to compound over time. And so with an example and a non-example, you are inviting students to be able to say, I know what this idea is because I can compare it to what it isn't.
If we truly understand the topic we're learning, you will know what is an example and what is a non-example.
We're in our last unit on body systems. We've just finished going through the 6 organ systems that we're learning, and now we're starting to really break down and understand how they work together.
We're going to do a card sort.
The activity we did today was an example, non-example lesson. My goal in doing this activity was to have them think a little bit more deeply about what is in the system and what isn't in the system, because if they can separate those two, I know that they've already got a good foundation.
You have your cards and you have your poster, you may start.
I passed out the sorting cards as well as posters that I created, and then I paired the students up with their cards and they started their discussions in sorting, and I said, be prepared to defend your choices.
These are kidneys, so that's an excretory.
Yeah. On the cards, we had pictures of different cells, pictures of organs, pictures of people doing activities that would connect to that system.
Do you agree that they belong in a non-example of a digestive and muscular system?
Yeah, because I don't think we have plant cells.
Correct. We do not have plant cells in our body.
This was not a final wrap-up assessment for this unit. We're still in the learning process. I was happy to see they were using their resources. I noticed the children were having really good discussions between them, saying, no, I think this actually, those cells don't belong there. Those cells belong over here. They were really trying to work out where the cards belonged and why they belonged there. And then I heard some nice disagreements.
Do you agree that it is both the circulatory and respiratory?
No. Well, it has the lungs, yeah. Which is in the respiratory system.
Uh-huh. I did circulate around the room, and then that kind of led me to think, okay, I see some of their misconceptions, I see some of their understanding, so I'm going to take all of the cards for all of the systems, and I use the overhead projector to show the two system names, and then from there, I would say, okay, guys, what do you think? Where does this belong?
Is this an example of either one of those systems?
No.
No, why? What is this?
Skeletal.
Okay, I'm gonna put that.
I let then the students share out their thoughts.
You think it's the nervous system?
Yeah.
Why, Maddie?
Because when, if you were like to touch like a hot pan, your brain would give your hand the signal to pull away.
All right.
Examples and non-examples are best used when you want to make absolutely sure that the conceptual understanding is built on a very solid foundation. And in playing both sides of examples and non-examples, you get richer manifestations of the idea that you want students to engage in.
Good. How'd we do on that one? All right, carefully put away your cards.